16-valve engine, and right now we've got the biggest Pulsar selection ever, so we've got to make you a great deal. Come in now and we'll sweeten the deal with factory incentives that could save you up to $500 more. Big selection, year-end savings, and factory incentives. This could be your last chance to get a great deal on the hot new Pulsar. Get big year-end savings at your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer.
Well, if you watch this on Sunday mornings, you see the beauty of the Furman surroundings, the surroundings around Paladin Stadium, Paris Mountain there, and how really nice it is, especially this kind of time of year. And the beautiful campus at Furman has to create a pretty good working environment too, doesn't it, Coach?
It's a great place. We have a great campus. This is an excellent place to watch a football game. Had a good crowd out there yesterday. And it's just, we have some recruits over yesterday. It's a good place to bring them into.
I don't know if you can really tour Furman University in 2.5 minutes. We're going to try to do that in just a second. Tell us a little bit about our tour guide this morning.
Well, we have Lee Satterfield here on the tour guide, and hopefully she can tell us a little bit about the campus.
Well, I'm sure she will. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at Furman University.
Founded in 1826, Furman University, a private coeducational college with 2,500 students, has established a reputation as one of the finest liberal arts colleges in the nation. Academic excellence is a tradition here at Furman University. Here on campus at the library, students come to enjoy each other's company, study, and research. University might be one of the greatest places in the world for jogging and biking. You can find them out here all hours during the day, early in the morning, late at night, even in the heat of the day. Another popular spot on Furman's campus is the 30-acre lake. Overlooking this lake is the bell tower. The lake's a popular spot on campus for boating, fishing, feeding the ducks, swimming also. Speaking of fishing, we ran across a couple of players over here. Patrick Bain and Keith Swilling. Hey guys, how y'all doing?
Not too well.
Not too well?
Not going too well.
How about you, Patrick? You catching anything?
I had a bite all day.
You're kidding!
No bites.
Tell the truth, Patrick. Is this the real reason you came to Furman University?
The only reason. It's a nice lake out here.
One of the many recreations at Furman is swimming in the Pack Building. Racquetball. Tennis. Golf. Softball. A proud heritage, strong academics, excellent facilities, and excellence in athletics are all part of one of the nation's top liberal arts colleges, Furman University.
All right, Coach, how'd you like that tour?
Lee did a good job. Someone said that Furman would be a great place to go to school if you didn't have to go to class.
All right. Now, how about that lake? Are there fish in there?
I think there are a few fish in there. Patrick's caught a few. They caught a nice one that day. They didn't show it. It came up with a big tin can, I think.
About an 18-pounder, huh?
That's right.
All right. Well, of course, the Paladins play football. They're not professional fishermen. And we'll come back and take a look at next Saturday's ball game against the Marshall Thundering Herd right after you take a look at this.
Looking for a great deal on the economy car ranked number one in quality? Your Nissan dealer's got it. With big year-end savings on all Nissan Sentras, we've got the best selection ever of quality-built Sentras with prices starting at $66.39. And right now, we'll sweeten the deal with factory incentives that could save you up to $500 more. Big selection, year-end savings, and factory incentives. This could be your best chance ever to get a great deal on a great car. Get big year-end savings at your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer.
All right, Furman Paladins off two successive losses now, unfortunately. Western Carolina last week, UT Chattanooga yesterday. Marshall's coming in. I think some people say, well, at least you got a breather now. That's not exactly true, is it?
Marshall's got one of the best teams in the league. They were last year one of the best teams offensively. They're better on offense probably than Western and Chattanooga. They throw the ball a lot. They just got off of a win yesterday, and they'll be a real tough opponent for us.
Do they throw it as much as they used to when Fodor was the quarterback?
Probably not quite that much, but they got a junior college quarterback who's been real successful throwing the football. And Marshall was one of the best teams we played last year. We had one of our best games against them, and they'll be a tough opponent.
So this will probably be a high-scoring affair coming up next Saturday at Paladin State.
Probably will be. Hopefully it wouldn't, but it probably will be.
Well, we'll keep our fingers crossed on that. What's going to be the key to getting back on the winning ways for you?
Well, I think the basic key is for us to rush the football better. We've rushed the ball some, but over the years we've led the conference in rushing the football. We've led the nation in rushing the football. And right at the end of the game yesterday, we had two plays that were keys. We had a sweep where we just gained 2 yards, had a base play where we didn't gain any yards. To me, I think we've got to rush the football better where the
other... ...for children, and with a few simple precautions...
...risking their lives to save another. At the Vietnam Vet, with no legs of his own, is walking to raise money for the men still listed as missing in action. Once again, we're proving that. Lawrence County is building a new library to keep in touch with the information processing demands of today and of the future. Included in this modern facility will be computers, audiovisual equipment, and other materials to better serve the people of Lawrence County in education, business, and recreation. But for this new library to become a reality, your financial support is necessary. With 18 translators serving you.
It's a 2nd and 15 for the Paladins of Furman from the 30-yard line of Marshall. Moore will drop back. He's going to give it to Bagwell on the draw. Bagwell goes up the middle, breaks left side. He's got some room. He breaks the tackle of one man, climbs over another at the end zone. It's a Furman touchdown.
The tradition continues. Furman Football 87, the Jimmy Satterfield Show. Brought to you by your upstate Nissan dealer. And by Pepsi, the taste born in the Carolinas.
Looking for the best truck deal in town? Your Nissan dealer's got it. With sensational year-end savings up to $900 on the biggest selection of hard-body trucks and rugged four-wheel drive Pathfinder.
Furman win, and yesterday a very, very good Furman win at Paladin Stadium in Greenville, 42-36 over the Marshall Thundering Herd. And I know, Coach, last Sunday morning we were sitting here talking about Marshall, and I guess we were pretty prophetic because we were talking about how many points were going to be scored, and that's just about what happened.
There were a lot of points scored. Fortunately, we scored the most, and it was a great win for us.
1,000 yards total offense in this ball game.
They had over 500. We had over 400, and we scored at the end to win the game, and I think we had a good effort from our players, and it was just a positive effort, and it already carried us a long way.
Certainly was a very exciting football game yesterday at Paladin Stadium in Greenville. And before we take a look at the highlights from the Marshall ball game, let's take a look at the players of the week from last week's game against UT Chattanooga.
Looking for for the best deal on a new luxury car? Your Nissan dealer's got it. With sensational year-end savings on all Stanzas and Maximas, we've got the best selection ever of quality-built Nissan cars, and we've got to move them fast. Come in now, and we'll sweeten the deal with factory incentives that could save you up to $700 on Stanzas or up to $900 on Maximas. Big selection, year-end savings, and factory incentives. Get the deal of a lifetime. Get big year-end savings at your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer.
Well, fans, it all comes down to this moment. This is where it all gets decided. Johnson steps in, checks the signs, makes a few adjustments. This is a classic confrontation. He's digging in. Here's the delivery. And there it goes. He's going back, back, way back.
Well, if you like exciting college football, yesterday's ball game at Paladin Stadium was definitely that. Furman against the Marshall Thundering Herd Southern Conference ball game. Let's go to the highlights from Gene Stone Field, Paladin Stadium, Greenville. Bright, sunshiny day, and here comes the Purple Paladins.
It was a great day for a ball game. A little windy, but I don't think that affected the game much.
Fumbled the opening kickoff, so then they get the football right off the bat.
Kelly Smith makes a good sack. We have a blitz on and sack the quarterback, and I believe we get 3 points out of this drive.
They do, a long field goal, and they missed some close ones later on, but they were able to hit that long one, so it's 3-0 in favor of the Herd. Here goes Lamar Bell.
Lamar makes a good little run on the draw play, but we don't get a first down in that drive.
Keith is going to throw it here to Larry Grady, 12 yards, but again, you have to punt. And Keith Moore looks like he played pretty well in the starting role.
He's played very good. Hit some good passes, ran some good options, and of course, he scored over 40 points.
That's a beautiful catch there by Mike Barber of Marshall, and that gives them a 10-0 lead. And as it turns out, that was the biggest margin either team had in the whole game.
They have some great receivers. He's one of them. They made some great catches, some excellent throws. Our defense did a good job hanging in there with them.
Pat Turner with a pretty good kickoff return here, and you had some pretty good returns on the day.
We had some good returns. Pat Turner, Angelo Richardson, we had some good plays on the kickoff return.
Second and nine, John Bagwell does his thing for the first time yesterday, and he gets 31 big yards.
John had a great day. A key block there by Fee Cowan to break that play.
How come the white hat, Coach?
Well, I'll have to tell you about that later.
Okay. Kenneth Goldsmith bursts up the middle, and he runs over about four or five Marshall guys.
Kenneth had a good day. We had some good inside plays when they were expecting the option, and had some nice runs.
Watch the guy burst up the middle here by Marshall. A field goal by Mike Wood is good, but that guy who burst up the middle hit the holder.
He roughs the kicker. We get a first down, and we score on a first play. Good block by Alex Albert. Kenneth Goldsmith makes a great block right there.
We'll have that from the other angle, and you can see number 35 just push his man right out of the way here.
Makes a good block along with Tim Fox on his man right there. He drives him in the end zone.
So it's 10-7 now. Marshall still up by 3 points over Furman, and the Herd gets the football back. They had three downs and punt, and one of those downs here is Brian Allison with a nice sack.
Brian makes a good play. They put a lot of pressure on your defensive line with all the passes they throw. I think they threw it 45 times. So a defensive line has to work very hard to rush the passer.
So we go into the second quarter, 10-7. Looks like it's going to be a high-scoring game at that point, and definitely that was right. They had a punt. You fumbled it, however, and they get it right back, and a great goal line stand here.
Excellent play. There's one of our former players, Benji Mott, looking on. Excellent play by our defense to keep them out of the end zone and keep them from getting on the board.
They had it first and goal at your three. Watch this play by Kelly Smith.
Good tackle by Kelly. Good pursuit by our linebackers, Adrian Dupre, Jeff Blankenship, and we make a good stop. They missed the field goal.
Fourth down, they missed a field goal. It was just a little bit longer than an extra point, so it's 10-7 Marshall. In defense of the kicker, though, it was quite windy, I think.
Very windy. It made it tough on the kicking game.
Third and two now for Furman at your own 28, and Dwight Sterling gets four tough ones.
Good run by Dwight. He played both ways yesterday, played offense and defense. That's pretty unusual.
There goes Keith Moore to Grady again.
Good throw, good execution, good blocking by our offensive line. Good protection.
Here comes the big play. Watch this one here to John Bagwell.
Good block by Fee Cowan. Good block by Tim. John makes a good cut. And John had a great day. It's probably one of the best days in Furman history as far as the tailback's concerned.
He had 175 yards in the first half, finished with about 220 on the day.
Had 220 yards rushing, had four TDs, a TD pass, two catches. Had a great day.
So that made it 14-10. Marshall came right back, though, scored, so it's 16-14. And then you had to punt the football, and this is pretty good coverage here by Pat Turner.
We had good coverage. Tommy Marshall does a good job of our kicking teams. He and Bruce Fowler in charge of the punt team, and we have good coverage. Pat Turner played good on the kicking teams, and we corral him.
So it's still 16-14 in favor of Marshall. They're going to fumble it here. And I've seen this play from about three different angles. I never saw it come loose, but obviously your guys did.
We get the fumble and had a couple of key turnovers that helped us get in the end zone.
All right, John Bagwell's going to break another one here for 17 yards.
Another good block by Fee Cowan and Elton Bailey. John gets a nice game.
On this particular possession, you missed a real long field goal, and again, Mike Wood came close on it.
We thought we might could make it with the wind, didn't quite hit it.
Good coverage there by Sherrod Weber. And this is another good stand because they're deep in your territory again. Again, Sherrod right there on the coverage.
They put a lot of pressure on our defense, and of course, they've got the best passer in the nation. And he didn't hurt himself any, I don't think, yesterday.
Looks like Julius may have gotten his hand in there and knocked that one away a little bit.
I think he did get a hand on it. We put a little pressure here. Probably should have made this tackle. This wasn't a good tackle. Good hit here by Pat Turner.
And saved a touchdown. They really had a fight for this score. They finally do get in. And on a fourth down play, they were able to dive on through there. But that's still pretty good defense.
Darby made a good play. He's a good player from Orangeburg.
22-14. They go for two. They don't quite get it.
Pat Turner on the... defense makes a good play.
So they lead it by eight, less than 2 minutes to go. 2 minute offense, I guess, could be called here, but you never put the ball in the air, and a pretty good kickoff return before we get the ball. And this is Tim Stansel.
Tim makes a nice return, gets out the midfield, and we were running options real good, so we decided to keep running the options.
Four plays, 52 yards for the touchdown. There's Bagwell for seven.
Bagwell makes a good run. Same play going the other way. And we have a good block here by Bill Duncan. Good cut by John. And Tim Sorrells makes a good call right here on the draw play. Alex Albert makes a good block. John makes a good run. And we thought John was capable of these kind of days before the season started, and he came up with it yesterday.
So that made it 22-20 in favor of Marshall, and now a two-point conversion try coming up.
Great pass by Keith with a defender right on him, and Larry makes a good catch, and we get 2 points.
I know last week, there it is, 22-22, 43 seconds to play, and that is going to be the halftime score. I know last week you were talking about how you thought you needed to run that sweep better, and that's definitely what you tried to come out and do yesterday.
Well, we wanted to rush the football better. We had over 300 yards rushing. You can see here a bunch of them, 211 in the first half. And our offensive line has been playing good all year. We just haven't been able to make the big play. John made some big plays yesterday and definitely helped our offense.
On the individual side yesterday, in the statistics in the first half, you see Bagwell, 174 yards rushing and already three touchdowns.
Well, the big plays help when you're rushing the football. You make the big plays, you don't have a lot of yards.
All right, very good. So it's 22-22 halftime at Paladin Stadium yesterday. And we'll come back and take a look at the second half highlights, Marshall against Furman, right after this.
In a recent survey of automobile quality, these two cars got the same excellent rating. The manufacturer of this car was rated number one in quality among Europeans. The manufacturer of this car was rated number one in quality among the Japanese. This car costs over $64,000. The Sentra costs about $6,400. Nissan puts quality in your price range. See your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer today.
Hi. I just moved in next door. Could I borrow a Diet Pepsi?
Sure.
Yes. Be right with you.
When you go all out for taste, the taste to go out for is Diet Pepsi.
You okay in there?
Here's a Diet Pepsi.
Thanks. I hope it wasn't too much trouble.
No trouble at all.
Diet Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Welcome back live on this Sunday morning with Coach Jimmy Satterfield. We're at halftime now, Paladin Stadium yesterday, 22-22. So you've played 30 minutes, Coach, and we're right back where we started.
Right where we started from. It was a great first half and a better second half for us.
I think so, too. Let's go ahead and take a look at those highlights. I don't know how this Paladin rides that bike with that big uniform.
Did a good job.
The Herd has it pretty early here, and nice pitch on the right side, but good play by Julius Dixon.
Julius, Russell Rush, Adrian Dupre. Some good tackle there by our defense.
This is a third down play here. I think they needed about nine. They don't get it.
Kelly Smith, Jeff Blankenship, Darrell Gardner make a good stop.
So it's Furman football, still a tie score early in the second half, and Kenneth Goldsmith's going to take it right up the middle.
They were stopping the option some, so went back to the inside game. Kenny makes a nice run.
Second down and 14 yards to go. Bagwell gets 13 here.
A good run by John. They have a blitz on the defense. Bill Duncan picks it up. We'll make a good run.
Didn't quite get the first down, so it's punt time. This is a key play.
Kevin Kendrick, you just noticed he was specialist of the week last week, and he makes this recovery, number 57 right there, gets the fumble.
So the Marshall guy muffs it there, so right now it's going to be Furman football again, and Kenneth Goldsmith is going to put him right back up the gut.
Another good inside play, good block by Alex Albert, we'll have a nice run inside for about five.
First down, and it's going to be John Bagwell, almost gets in, he gets out of bounds just inside the five.
Real good effort by John, breaks a tackle, makes a good effort to get extra yards.
Keith Moore's turn to get into the end zone. He's going to go ahead and stick it on in. It's now 29-22 Furman.
Another good block by 66, Pete Cowan, Bobby Kelly inside. Our offensive line played real good. You have to get over 300 yards rushing.
One thing about Marshall, we talked about it last week. We've already talked about it today. They're very explosive and only takes them a couple minutes to get back into the ball game and tie it up.
This is just good execution on their part. Number six made some nice cuts, a good run. He's another one of their very good receivers.
So it's 29-29. Again, we're back where we started again. And this right here is your return of the day, I think.
Well, this is Angelo Richardson. The returns kicks for us. He's made a nice cut, good decision, and gets the ball back out to midfield.
He almost breaks this thing.
Good cut and slips down, almost breaks it.
Fell down right there where the kicker's tee is, so he got on the 35-yard line. However, on that series, you had to punt, so they come right back, and almost an interception here by Sherrod Weber.
Good play by Sherrod, almost comes up with a good interception.
Then they had to punt, and then you had to punt back, so the defense is doing pretty good. Wayne Burr on the sack.
Good job by Wayne. Wayne's been filling in for Philip Ferguson. Philip injured his leg a little bit. Wayne comes in the fourth quarter and plays good.
Will Philip be able to play next week?
I think he probably will.
29-29 after three. Dr. John's leading the cheer here, so Marshall has it deep in your territory, and early in the fourth quarter, they're able to score again. They're up by seven.
They go up, and it seems like when they score, we do our best job on offense. So I think our players felt like they could get it back in the end zone.
12 and a half to play. Moore's going to go to Bell this time.
We were looking to throw deep, and we weren't open. Lamar makes a good catch, and we fumble the ball out of bounds. Luckily, it goes out, and we still get it.
Marshall gets it back a few plays later, though. A big defensive series here.
Good job by our defense, stopping when we had to, and Barber drops the ball there. Good coverage by Jerry Booker. We had a couple of defensive backs got hurt. Jerry had to go in and play good.
See, they're leading by seven here, and that was a third down and nine. They keep going deep. Why is
that? Well, we were blitzing, and they tried to go deep. Julius made a good play, had good coverage.
The Paladin on the bicycle again, so it's third and ten in favor for Furman now, and Keith Moore's going to go to Gandy, a big game.
Big play here. We need the first down. Steve makes a great catch after they hit him, and we have a first down. We get several key first downs right here on third and eight, seven and eight.
Dwight Sterling here with a pretty good run.
Good run by Dwight. Of course, I mentioned before that he played some nose guard and tailback, and it's quite unusual.
How about Keith Swilling here?
Keith makes a great catch. Seems that he catches better than he fishes.
Second down and at the Marshall 20-yard line, John Bagwell turns quarterback.
Super catch by Keith. He dives. He's one of the best receivers on the team. Of course, he was filling in for an injured Tim Fox.
So, Furman, there you see 36-36. That's going to be the score after Mike Woods sticks the conversion through there. And obviously, a very big point after touchdown here.
Very big. Mike hits a good one, and we tie the game up.
So, it's 36-36. Again, we're right back where we started. 6:45 to play. And pretty good kickoff coverage now by your specialty teams.
We kick it in the end zone. They try to run it out and get it on about the six, I think. This is very good coverage. This is one of the best returners in the nation, Darby, and that's a good hit. I couldn't tell exactly who made the hit. Excellent coverage by our special team.
There's the white hat again. Are you going to tell us about it yet?
Keith and I are over there together.
They move it pretty well, and they get down deep in your territory. That was a third down play, and you stopped them. So now it's fourth down. Another short field goal attempt coming up here.
They missed the field goal. It was a close one. And we have a chance now to get back on board and win the game.
He missed it two times, both times to the left in about the same situation.
Pretty windy, like you mentioned, and it probably had some effect on it.
You had four big third down plays in the winning drive, and this is one of them.
Good play here, a delay play. These plays have worked good throughout the year. Bruce Fowler's done a good job of a passing game and called some of the good men of these plays right in here to get us on the board.
That's third and eight now. Keith Swilling, he shows his speed here.
Shows some speed there. They outrun some of their defenders and makes a nice game.
We're going to see that one from the ground side, too, and that's going to put the ball on the Marshall 27-yard line. So you got to feel good. You're in Mike Wood range now.
Well, we feel like we get a field goal right in here. That's basically what we're working for. but they end up getting a touchdown, maybe a little easier.
This is third down, 13 yards to go, and Larry Grady on the receiving end.
I thought this really showed a lot of confidence in Keith because he had just thrown this pass to the right and overthrown, and he wanted to throw it again, and I thought that was real positive on his part, helped us get in the end zone.
Did he tell you he wanted to throw it?
Yeah, he said, let's throw that corner out again and hit it. It was a big play for him.
And here's the biggest one of the day. Third down, 5 with the Marshall 6 and Bagwell right up the middle.
The offensive line actually called this. We had a timeout, and they came over and said, I believe that play we put in will work, the lead play, which is a good block by Ed Patterson, who's filling in for injured Mark Brown. Mark's been one of our best offensive linemen, probably lost him for the season with an injury yesterday. He's been a real good player for us.
So it's 42-36. Unfortunately, you missed the extra point there, so they have a chance to win.
Well, it worried us a little bit. That's the same score we had when we scored late in the game against Georgia Southern. We had 42 points and lost, but we came up with a good one on this pitcher back.
We threw it over the middle. Blankenship there with the stop, and here comes the defensive player of the game, I guess, by Julius Dixon.
Well, he threw it 45 times, and the 45th one went to us, and I think that shows a lot of patience, a lot of determination by our players that they hung in there, and Julius made a great play when we needed it, and we did what we had to do to win.
What was it like on the sidelines? It must have been like an emotional turmoil in your mind, wasn't it?
Well, it was an up and down game, but I think you just got to keep your patience and poise and hang in there, and we've done it before. I think our guys expected to win. It's probably had a lot to do with us getting a victory.
42-36 was the final score. The game statistics very close. Marshall, maybe the slight edge, but statistics lie all the time.
Well, they do. We had turnovers. We had 5 turnovers, more turnovers than we had the last 2 weeks when we lost games. But the big thing was the score, and we had 42 points, and offense and defense did some good things for us to win.
And a lot of times when you see those big passing yard totals, the winning team isn't always the one that has those.
Well, that's true. You've got to be able to rush your football, and I think they did move it through the air real good. And obviously, they're one of the best in the country, but we did some good things also and got the points when we need them.
On the individual side, John Bagwell, 213 yards, officially rushing 4 touchdowns. He carried it 27 times. Kenneth Goldsmith with a good game as well.
Well, when John carries it that many times, he's going to have a chance to get some good yards than he did yesterday. Of course, Gardner and Blankenship have played good every week. Kelly Smith, another fine game.
Kelly Smith really in a substitution, I guess, on a full-time role for Tim Steppen, and he stepped right in there and really done a good job.
Played very good, and he was injured most of the week, didn't get to practice much, but he's a hard-nosed kid and a real competitive guy.
So big offensive showdown yesterday at Paladin Stadium. The Paladins up on top of Marshall. The final score 42-36, and the Paladins win it after losing 2 in a row. The past couple of weeks, the running game faltered at times for Furman. But yesterday against Marshall, things were working well.
Keith did a great job. He read the tackle and read the end real well and made the end commit, and I was just wide open when he pitched it to me, so he had a lot to do with option today.
And so did the offensive line, clearing the way for Bagwell to run and giving Moore enough time to throw.
That's the key to our passing game. We've got a fairly complex passing game. If we can keep the guys off the quarterback long enough, we can complete some passes, and this is a credit to them. They did a great job.
They're big and strong. They're big and strong, but we utilized our quickness and got on them where they couldn't do anything. So I really felt good about that. We had the right schemes, and all we had to do was block them, and we did. And it's opened everything up for them. It was an excellent, excellent performance by Bagwell. He was really awesome today.
But what about the defense? It did give up 36 points, but then again, it also stopped Marshall several times in key situations, giving the Furman offense the opportunity to take it on in.
When you got near the goal line and we came up with some big plays, especially the last drive where Julius Dixon intercepted the ball, I think we just meant to win. I mean, we worked hard all week and we did it. We did what we had to do. We gave a little too many points. But in the end, we stuck together and the defense really came around. The offense punched it in and we came out on top.
If you're looking for quality in a new car, take a look at these. They're why Nissan is rated number one. A recent independent survey named Nissan number one in quality and reliability among all Japanese and domestic manufacturers. And now your Nissan dealer has special factory incentives that could save you hundreds. So if you want a car that's truly reliable, if you want a car with real quality priced right, see your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer today.
a burger with everything and a large fries.
You need a drink?
Yeah, a Coke. I meant a Pepsi.
If you want great refreshment, just say what you mean.
Make that two Pepsis?
Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Looking for a great deal on the hottest sports car around? Your Nissan dealer's got it. With big year-end savings on the sensational Pulsar NX with a powerful 16-valve engine. And right now, we've got the biggest Pulsar selection ever. So we've got to make you a great deal. Come in now and we'll sweeten the deal with factory incentives that could save you up to $500 more. Big selection, year-end savings, and factory incentives. This could be your last chance to get a great deal on the hot new Pulsar. Get big year-end savings at your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer.
Well, a Saturday afternoon at Paladin Stadium, very exciting, as we just saw a very exciting game yesterday. And really, there are several teams that make it exciting. The football team, the team of coaches, and another team that really doesn't get a whole lot of publicity, but is very important, especially getting the things exciting at Paladin Stadium on Saturday. And that's the team of cheerleaders at Furman. This looks like work. Well, this looks like a lot of fun. And it probably is fun. But for the Furman cheerleaders, getting ready for the Marshall game takes about as much work as the players put in.
We usually practice four times a week for 2.5 to 3 hours every time we practice. And then in addition to that, we have the public relations things that we show up for and the games.
And just as with the football team, the week of preparation for the cheerleaders comes together at the games.
Our routines this year are a lot more difficult, I think, than last year. And that's why it's harder, I guess, to get them all together. Last year, we had a lot of easy material that we executed really well. But this year, we're trying to put more difficult material in. So it's taking quite a while just to get it together. But it's a lot more exciting. We're using music this time that everybody knows. So I think it'll be better.
Naturally, the main job of the cheerleaders is to get the crowd fired up on Saturday, which in turn should get the team fired up.
Even this past Saturday, they mentioned a lot of times that they heard the student body over here on the other side, and that really helped them keep going.
Wherever they need us the most, we just kind of get out there and do whatever it takes to get the fans going good.
Now, the Furman cheerleaders are grouped into pairs. So while Guy A works with the team, he's permanently paired with Girl A. The same goes for Guy B and Girl B, and so on and so forth down the line.
That's really important because you get your timing together and you really learn. Each girl has a different balance and different timing. And we've been working together since the spring, all of our couples, so that our time is together and the guys know how each of the girls like their stunts.
It takes a lot of work to get the timing of each individual couple together. And for instance, if somebody were to quit now and we had to replace one of the members of the couple, it would take them a lot of time to get the timing back together. So it's essential to have good timing.
And it's also essential to be in good shape. Now, you don't have to be a Mr. or Miss Atlas to do it, but you also can't be a couch potato either and expect to pull it off.
A guy without a lot of muscle and good timing can be a cheerleader and can be a very good cheerleader, but a little strength doesn't hurt. A guy who's not a real strong person can be stunting with a girl who's 115, 120 pounds, and if their technique and their timing is right together, they'll have no problem getting into a stunt. But a guy can be, you know, he can bench 200 pounds and have a girl who's 100 and not get her into a stunt if their timing isn't together.
And how successful this group will be, or for that matter, how successful any group can be, gets back to preparation.
A lot of people just think, oh, you're a cheerleader, you practice, you know, maybe 2 hours a day, 3 or 4 times a week. But it's a lot more than that, I guess, going out into Greenville and, you know, it's a lot of PR work and little things that, you know, we do for the athletic department. And also, as well as doing things for the athletic department, we have the whole student body, too. So we're kind of a mediator between the student body and the football team, so we end up doing pretty much both.
Looking for a great deal on the economy car ranked number one in quality? Your Nissan dealer, HBO.
Arthur Beneker may have been abandoned,
but he's not alone.
I've been on my own my whole life. What I want's a family.
We are family.
Yeah, we know that.
The following information is classified.
We're almost out of time here on this Sunday morning, but Coach, we've been asking you about this white hat. Why were you wearing the white hat yesterday?
Well, last year we had some good luck with the white hat, and Keith Moore always needs somebody he can recognize over. That's the reason I originally had it last year, but my son is a manager on the team, and he felt like maybe it'd bring us some good luck. I lost the hat when we moved, but he came over and found it in the garage and felt like maybe it'd bring us some good luck.
You think it'll bring good luck next week against East Tennessee?
I hope so. We'll try it again.
That is an excellent football team, isn't it?
They have a very good team. They're right in the top.
October 17th and 18th, Main Street, Greenville. Broadway is coming to Spartanburg. Roger Miller's Tony Award-winning musical, Big River, will be at the Spartanburg Memorial Auditorium for three big nights, October 12th through the 14th at 8 p.m. Monday, October 12th, is Hardee's, Quincy's, and TV7's premiere night. Get $3 off the regular ticket price for premiere night by picking up a discount coupon at all area Hardee's and Quincy's family steakhouses. Tickets are on sale now. For additional information, call 803-582-8107. With 18 translators serving you,